Nestled in the corner of the Eastern Caribbean, this spice island is known for its nutmeg and its cool, laid-back vibe. We were lucky enough to hook up with Lexanne, a former Miss Grenada, who was only too happy to show us around.
Thanks, Rachel. Welcome to my beautiful island home of Grenada, the spice of the Caribbean. Yes, Grenada is famous for spices, namely our flavorful nutmeg. Well, today I'm going to take you on my personal tour of the Spice Island.
The air is perfumed with the scents of cinnamon, nutmeg, and cloves as it lingers over St. George's, the capital of Grenada, a country of unspoiled natural beauty located in a tranquil region of the West Indies. Grenada is called the Hot Island because there are more spices per square mileage than any other. And we Grenadians are pretty creative in its uses.
It's all about the Papi's product. Welcome to Island Styly. And Papi, tell us, how did you start making these wonderful products?
My vision by start making this product, by making different drinks, different quality drinks. I do a lot of research with the different herbs. Good. We use the Boabandi, we use the Black Sage, Albe, and many things like Tiwit.
Do you also use the nutmeg or any of the other spices? How do you use them to actually produce a drink?
Jelly with the nutmeg, I make jam, I make syrup, and I also make the wine out of nutmeg. You know, let them come and see what Grenada have to offer.
Grenada, full of flavor and so rich in history and culture. Did you know that Grenada produces most of the world's nutmeg? No other island in the Caribbean can spice things up the way we can. That's what makes us so unique. For those seeking a little history lesson, be sure to visit Leapers Hill. Just don't jump, okay? Enough of that in our history. Shopping is always on the agenda when you travel, right? Well, sometimes you want something unique and maybe a little out of the norm, but definitely original.
Well, we're here at the boutique and we, of course, we're going to be checking out what I like to call and what Lilo calls wearable art. It's all about batik designs and they're fantastic. And you can see them right here. Lilo, tell us a little bit about the history of art fabric.
Okay, art fabric 20 years ago. One lady started this in just this place where we are now. And I came later, I sailed in over the ocean to Grenada and I met this lady and I started to be here now about 12 years. I'm doing the design and my spirit is into what we're doing. Everything what I do is just there, you know, because everything is hand painted, everything is an original, one of a kind and made all in Grenada with Grenadians.
How long does it actually take you to complete one of these pieces?
First make the pattern, then we have to cut it in white, then the seamstress is gonna sew it, then it comes back and then we have the design on it and wax over. A week it takes until it's finally in the boutique. Yeah.
Well, you know what, Lilo, hats off to you. And of course, we want to let everyone know that Art Fabric is in existence in Grenada. Come on down when you visit the Spice Isle.
Added to the culture of the island of Grenada is medicine. For 30 years, St. George's University has attracted the finest and brightest students from all corners of the globe, producing numerous medical and business professionals.
Colin, the university is celebrating 30 years of existence. Could you tell us a little bit more about that?
The idea was to produce a school for American students who had difficulty because of the number of seats available in the U.S. To study in the field of medicine. We have grown significantly beyond that as you take a look at the campus. We became a full university in 1996 with the introduction of undergraduate programs. Started a school of veterinary medicine in 98. We have graduate programs going on. So it has been a fun ride for this institution.
Now we know that St. George's University is mainly about medicine, but tell us a little bit more about the other programs offered here.
It is important that we are relevant to Grenada and to the Caribbean. So we started the undergraduate programs and we have a number of different areas in business, information technology, in the humanities, in the basic sciences for persons who don't necessarily want to do medicine.
I live in Grenada, so it was convenient to come to school right at home. And then The area of study I wanted to go to was right here, so it makes life a lot easier.
I wanted the opportunity to have a different experience as well as be close enough to home. And you know, Grenada is similar enough to Trinidad, where you know you could just escape by beaches, beautiful beaches, and it's a conducive environment for our field of study because it is a demanding field, and I think that we need some form to release the tension.
Our professors are here, over 200 of them dedicated towards the students' development.
The destiny of this piece of cane? Sugar? No, man, rum. So Whitfield, you probably have the greatest job on this island.
I would think so. I work at one of the oldest rum distillery that is there on the island. I really love what I do. It's wonderful here.
Now, what makes it so special what you do? I mean, what is the best part of your day?
Well, the best part of my day, and it's really my job, I get to meet people from literally all over the world. Come here at this old distillery to explore, to see how rum has been made the authentic way. And that is what you'll get here, authentic rum. We have the only actually working water wheel left in the Caribbean, and that is where our means of power comes from to get our cane crush. Here we do the concentration of our juice, the fermenting of it, the distilling of the actual fermented juice, and here we do the entire process. And it is really, really, really unique to look at, really nice to see.
You went as far back as 1785, so tell me something. Do you have any samples from 1785 that I can try?
Unfortunately, no. At present, we are unable to meet our demands. Mm-hmm. Our rum is such a popular rum on the island that we cannot afford to have our rum stored or aged or anything of that sort.
Okay.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that little taste of our spice isle. See you soon, right here in Grenada.
Thanks for the invitation, Lexanne, and thank you guys for watching. I hope you've had as much fun as I've had, and you've learned a little bit more about this wonderful place that we call home. I'm Rachel, and wherever your final destination may be today, walk good and take care.